what I like to do to get a good clover plot established is I don't like to, I try to stay away from planting clover plots in the spring because you're going to deal with a lot of weed competition and it's going to be very frustrating for you. So what I like to do is, you know, come fall, I like to have my food plot, you know, where I want to plant it. I'm going to get it established. It's, you know, have the soil sample done, so forth. Get your pH right so you know that you're, when you're spending the money for an expensive clover seed, that it's going to grow first and foremost. And then what I like to do, you know, get you a nice seed bed, you know, pick all your rocks and stuff out of there, because keep in mind, you're going to be mowing these food plots because they're going to be clover. So they're going to be need maintained. Pick all your rocks up, your sticks and so forth like that. Try to get your seed bed as level as you can. And then what I like to do, I like to seed it, you know, kind of with a cover crop, whether it be turnips, you know, oats, wheat, rye, anything as far, you know, just a cover crop over my clover. Once I seed it with that, I'll come through and I'll roll it, pack it in. And then I'll come through and I'll seed it fairly heavy with the clover. You know, there's lots of different varieties of clover out there. I like to use Whitetail Institute Imperial Clover. My deer love it here in this part of Ohio. So, you know, I pay attention to what my deer like, so that's what I plant. You know, and that's what I do. And then come, you know, all fall, I have, you know, nice groceries in my food plot, different varieties. And then come springtime, I've got a lush carpet of clover popping up. I just come through, fertilize it, mow it, maintain it, and I've got a great, you know, perennial clover plot for the next 4 or 5 years. Just a little tip for a lot of guys that are planting food plots. You know, some may do it, some don't. What I've ran into a lot in the past is if once you have a food plot, an area you want to go in and food plot, is you spray it, then you till it up, and then you go ahead and seed it. Well, when you're tilling it, once you spray it and it's dead, and then you're tilling it up, all you're doing, you're bringing a bunch of seeds, you know, Mother Nature seeds, you know, just seeds that have been sitting there dormant, you're bringing them back up to the surface. And those are germinating as well with the seed that you've just broadcast on top of the ground. And typically those will choke out your food plot. So what I like to do is I'll burn it off, get it, you know, nice and burned off and get it as short as I can. I'll mow it down, come in, I'll work it up and I'll let it sit for about 2 weeks. And then I come back in and burn them off again. You know, anything that I brought to the surface that's been sitting there dormant, they've germinated, they've started to grow. And I come in and I nuke them off with a herbicide, and then I seed what I want to seed. That way I don't have all that weed competition, grass competition coming up in my food plot.